from Ghana, actually.
Which place do you know? Huh? Where do you know in Ghana? Accra?
Kumasi?
Kumasi?
I know Tema.
Tema.
And Takoradi.
Takoradi, yes. Wow, you know everywhere in Ghana. This is Ecobank's headquarters in Mali. Welcome to another vlog. If you're new here, I'm coming at you straight from Mali, Bamako. So you guys, welcome to Mali, the cradle of civilization and the land of one people, one faith and one goal. So is this the most expensive luxurious five-star hotel here in Mali? Let's go find out.
The first time I heard about a product being rated with stars was when I had to download WhatsApp on my Android phone because I couldn't afford a BlackBerry phone, which was the ish in those days, and I so much desired one. Almost everyone in my circle was using a BlackBerry phone, and I knew I deserved one as well, because the girl within me just felt being left behind. If you can relate to that era, kindly let me see you in the comment section. It was pretty crazy in those days, but that is beside the point. What exactly makes a product 5 stars?
Let's get going. We'll get there soon to find out if that is the most luxurious 5-star hotel. You know, on the streets of Mali, almost everywhere is a market. Any little space that is unoccupied and is viable for selling something, yeah, you see people park there with their, you know, products displayed for sale. So yeah, man has to survive. If there is no employment, you need to try and, you know, create one for yourself. So that's exactly what they do.
I guess by now you guys are wondering in your beautiful brains, why does this girl keep licking her lips like they are lollipop? Of course, that is a good question to ask, but you can only understand if you live in a highly humid weather like I am right now. It is so stifling, my tongue can't help but come out of its little shelf to keep those lips wet so they don't look cracked up like cream cracker cookies.
I can't even explain it to you. The signpost there says that we are going to the airport and also Kambilai and Jikoroni. I'm fine, how are you? Left. No. Sorry.
Wait.
First. Okay, like I told you, some people can be extremely nice, some too, no. So you do what the people prefer. If they want you to film them, then you do. If they don't, you just pass by. I told you, any little empty space is a place for selling something. So exactly so, that is the army barracks right here. So you don't film here, so I will try and hide my camera. Wow, look at this. They are so beautiful. Merci. Ça va bien. That side is leading to Hamdelai and the airport. And this side is leading to where we are going to. On the barracks walls, we have Morris Yamiogo. So let me not lie, I can't see it from afar. So you see that side? If I show you that side, I cannot walk there, but it's extremely beautiful. It's a highway, so you just find vehicles riding there. Yeah, what's up, how are you?
Okay.
Ça va? Yeah. Ça va?
Salut.
Okay. This place too has a lot of trees, so when they wither, they saw the place. So yeah, That is why you see lots of leaves falling. But we are not in the fall, right? Very close to us, we are at the Eagles Monument. You can see it there, up there. You know, Mali is full of monuments. It either depicts history or some kind of inspiration. You know, eagle depicts strength or something, yeah. I should think so, that eagle depicts strength. Look at the landscaping. Look at the landscaping here. They love trees. They try as much to plant trees and level them very well. Their flowers are always well lawned, and it makes places very nice. Messy. So I just want to find out what is there. Sorry, pardon. What's that? So this monument, sometimes they are like parks. It's just like, you know, the park I showed you in Accra, with trees that people sometimes just come and, you know, hide under the shades for some fresh air. These people, they are selling. When they get tired, they just come and relax here for a while and continue their work. You know, you find a lot of them, they are not necessarily homeless. Sometimes they go to work, they are tired, and then they just want to hide under some kind of shade. So I love that about them. No matter what, they try as much to do some work, something, to do something for themselves. Okay? So what you are seeing right there is the monument of the eagle. Here is leading to, I say, Demil Hamdulai and Jikoroni. If you want to cross the road, oh my goodness, you need to do some form of magic. So is it necessary that I go there? You let's go there and find out what they have written on those things there. I told you, if you want to cross here, it's about a lot of hard work. Hey, if I follow you, the cars will hit me. Let me just do my thing. Hey! They are remaining here till tomorrow. Hey! So this is the monument of the eagle. First, sir, do not mind me. Okay. We want to find out what is here.
The sovereignty. The notes on this post denote sovereignty, with the president, His Excellency Mr. Assimi Gwaita, declaring this day, the 14th of January, as a national day of restored sovereignty. Sovereignty of the nation, the sovereign choice of the people, and the interests of the people. But my question is, can Africa ever become sovereign? If you think so, kindly drop in the comment section what factors must be put in place for this to happen. Because from time to time, we get one good leader or the other emerging who fights for the liberation of this continent, but there is always a mole around them who trades everything but for their own self-gratification. We can talk about the likes of Kwame Nkrumah, the likes of Gaddafi, and what's not, but all to no avail. So my question again is, can Africa ever become sovereign?
Are you okay? Is that okay? So this is my outfit of the day. That is how I've been dressing here in Mali. Because of the sun, you see what I'm doing. I've covered my whole face with a scarf, right? Bonsoir. So that's what I do. And I'm all covered, guys. I don't want no criticisms when I come out. Even with this, people still look at me so weirdly sometimes. Do you get? Because, like, you hardly find a lady wearing a cap or, like, doing all the kind of things that I'm doing. Because of the sun, I try to always cover myself. But they do use their, is it hijab? You know, the Muslim thing that they use to cover themselves. That is what they use. And me, I just use, like, my scarf to tie my hair and use my hoodie and do all kind of stuff to myself. So they look at me so strangely, like, do you get? All right, guys, I'll see you in the GP. You can see up there, the police is right there watching us. So we gotta keep ourselves in order. So I'll talk to you guys much, much later. Bye. You see where we are? We're getting closer. We're getting closer. The building you are seeing right there is called the Administrative City. And here is the Modibo Keita Memorial, this side. Yeah. So we are going to a hotel here called the Azalai Hotel. So come along with me. Let's go. I told you, Mali is full of very well catered to salons and beautiful landscaping. That is the hotel we are going to right there. I don't actually know where the entrance is, but let's go. There are coconuts, but I've never seen a single coconut. Like here in Bamako, I've never seen anyone selling coconuts, and I do crave for coconuts a lot. Sometimes I'm walking under the sun and my throat feels so dried and all I need is some coconuts, but I don't get some. Wow, the architecture, look at that, the round thing showing there. I don't know if you can see. Azalai Hotel.
Having entered the security post of the Azalai Hotel, I had to be thoroughly checked. They check you for anything metal, anything that can destroy lives. I just want to let you know that this is always the case in every public place in Bamako. Although I have experienced this in Lagos before, this is certainly on another level. Given that I was even holding a camera, they had to take me to their manager to find out if it is okay for me to carry the camera around.
Hey, jolly, jolly. Alright, where? Okay, welcome to the Azalai Hotel, you guys. Look at how beautiful this place is. Look at the lawning. Oh my goodness. The landscaping, everything here is so cool. Look at the building. Wow. Oh my God.
You guys, I'm loving it already. Look at just how those plants are well kept in their pots. And the floor is so clean and shiny, you guys. Oh my goodness, this is very exotic. What do you think? Does it already look 5 stars from without? Just look at that. Look at that flower pot over there. Look at the plant inside. Oh my goodness, look at these glass doors. Oh my God, the reflection. Oh my goodness, this is gorgeous. Man, this is the nicest place I've been in Bamako, and you guys can attest to that. And now this is the reception stroke lounge, and I'm just asking of where their restaurant is so we can just go ahead to that place. So look at that plant in that basket of a flower pot beside that reflective board. So beautiful. And look at the tiling of the place. I mean, the interior design of this place is on another level. The lighting is top-notch. The contrast of the color is what I love most, not forgetting the couches. Oh my God, the whole place looks lavishing. They have an elevator here, but we are going right outside as that is where they have directed us to the restaurant. Oh my goodness, look at that. Look at that. If you are not loving it already, just tell me what you are not loving about this piece. Look at the exterior, okay? The greenery is something else. Look at that little plant by the wall. I so much love it. The pool, they are now working on it. Oh my goodness. Let's just walk straight to that bar and see what they have. Look at this flower. They just lawned it so perfectly. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. If I tell you that this place is the hottest climate I've ever been in, you will not even believe it, because everywhere you go is green and you'll be wondering, how do they make this happen? That just shows how hardworking they are, of course. So this is the restaurant, and I was surprised to know that they only have snake food here. Oh my goodness, I run. As soon as I heard snake, I was away. You guys, let's listen.
That's a restaurant.
Restaurant, please. Inside.
Inside. Wow.
It's spa.
This is spa. Okay, that's cool. Let me just see. What? Coca-Cola?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Just Coca-Cola.
Just
Hello. Okay. Snake restaurant.
Yeah.
Here. They sell snake. No. So I so I want to go inside. But I passed there. When I said restaurant, they asked me to come here. Okay. Burger. Merci.
I can vividly remember the first time I heard about snake, lizard, or frog for food. That was when my auntie was working in a Chinese restaurant. But for a black restaurant to tell me all they serve is snake for food, that was it for me. I was like, okay, I'm on my way.
One of the 5-star hotels here in Mali Bamako, right here in Hamdulai. So if you're here and you know you want to have a good time, yeah, this is it. Here we come at Sailor Hotel,
which comes with 112 guest rooms. Look at that traditional port, so beautiful.
Alright, thank you. Then leave your blog. Let's have a drink and let's go, because you see the place is closed. The restaurant is closed. Look. Oh, look at this luxury, you guys. We are living life. Best life in Mali, Bamako. Yeah, let's sit in the AC. I just showed you outside. How do you check it?
Wow, guys, can you imagine? Here I am wanting to spend some cash on some good food, and all they can tell me is that the restaurant is closed. And I'm like, where in the world does this happen? Here, the restaurants have specific times that they are open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and you have to be conversant with the time, and you dare not miss it, because you are going to go hungry for the rest of the time until it is next open. This is my first time experiencing this, because where I'm coming from, restaurants to hotels are always opened, and you can walk in there at any time to have food. Perhaps they may be closed during the night, but within the day, they are always opened. So I ask, have you ever experienced this? If you have, kindly drop a comment and let me know.
The
first place I've come that they are singing English songs. I think I wonder. A tamarind.
Just tamarind?
Yeah.
So what? Three of Africa.
What?
I did not tell you. You need to be savvy with the internet. The digital era is here to stay. To order food, you need to first of all scan the code on the dining table to have access to the menu on the internet. Very modern and sophisticated.
All dressed in black with just a little strip of white in it, and oh my goodness, the place is so much in order. The outside looks good, the inside looks even super exotic.
I love the mirror.
The bar. I'm not going upstairs, but maybe I'll ask and see if they'll allow me to go upstairs and check. I just want to be showing you how it looks, but this is just like, the restaurant itself is closed, but this is the bar. And when you just want to relax, you can sit right there. You see how the receptionist is dressed. You see that?
I just love the way they are dressed. Their attire is good looking. You know, in Mali, even the security personnel, they make them dress like the police.
So when you say security personnel, sometimes you may not differentiate whether it's a policeman or a security man. That's the thing with them.
Me, I don't know the lyrics. Merci beaucoup. Well, so this juice is made of tamarind and it is, a glass is 2,000 safer. And the cheapest drink here is minerals like Coke, Fanta and all that. Those are 1,500 safer and this one is 2,000 safer. The restaurant is not open. I could have gotten us some food. But this is cool. At least I save my money. I go back home and eat and eat my local rice. Gotta save some money, right? So it's tamarind, it's made of tamarind. I don't know if I've tasted it before, but let me just taste it and see.
Okay, this thing, okay.
Do you know what it is? It tastes like Aliha. I don't know. Aliha. How did they call it? Asana. Asana in Ghana. That's why it is so much sugar.
It's like, you know, Asana is the drink that if they want to make it, they soak the maize for some days and then they boil it also and add some sugar, burnt sugar to it. Yes, for it to ferment, they soak the maize for some days and then they boil it and cook it in water. The water is what we call Asana. Those things taste like that.
Nothing special. Nothing special because the place is a 5-star hotel, so that is why. This is something you can get on the street for
10 cities. It will not even be up to. As long as if you have 2 cities, you can buy as one. So this is what you can get on the street for 2 cities or 5 cities in Ghana. That is what you are paying for. This is 2,000. 2,000 so far is like $4. Well, but it's so cheap. So cheap.
Even when I went to what is it called? There's this hotel in going to Kong. Something resort. That one to the a glass of juice is going for $4, like 40 cedis. It's the same thing.
This one should even be much expensive than that one, because this is a 5-star hotel. But in Mali, generally, something to eat and drink is very, very, very cheap. That is one thing about Mali.
Look at how that person is dressed.
He's carrying his whole body and his head. He's from the north. Can you see how he's dressed? That's how the northern people dress, the men, that's how they dress here. Their head, you see that kind of thing. When we see that, you feel like they are Boko Haram. But they are not. That is their culture. Alright guys, let's hurry up and go. I'll get back to you when I'm done with my drink.
There's a car here to pick the Mandala of Hotel's car. I don't know if you can see they are parking. They are going to the airport. You see the problem.
So tonight, can we go in the pool? Order some food or drinks? Possible to?
They said it's snake food. That was why I left there and came here. I don't want snake.
You don't like snake?
When I went there, he said the food there is snake. They offer.
Yes, there's only snake. So restaurant is open after 7 o'clock.
In the evening. Okay.
You don't have change.
Wow. I don't have change. Where do you say the washroom is?
A washroom there.
Where? Here. Okay. Okay, guys, look at that. This is the washroom. Oh, but I'm looking good. Okay. Here. Oh my goodness. Look at that. Hey, down. Down is women. Down, wow. If you can't speak French, there's some way. The place is so clean. It's kept so clean. Look at that. Wow.
Wow. It's
very clean. Wow, you guys, look. Oh, this is really a luxury hotel. Guys, at this point in time, I want to know the number of stars you have accorded the Azalai Hotel. Once upon a time, back in the days, according to my own experience, it was only tech products that were rated using stars as a correlation between the products and how good they were. Little did I know that stars will become a household name for rating every other product, whether tech or physical, including real estate. In this context, we are talking about this hotel, which is real estate. Okay, so yeah, I know that for a hotel to be rated 5 stars depends on the individual experience of the customers. I stand to be corrected. It may depend on how luxurious the place is, the interior decor of the place, the structure of the hotel, how clean the place is looking, and many other factors. It also depends on the customer service and the human relations of the personnel working in the hotel. So it all depends on individual experiences. So someone may rate the place 5 stars because the place is neat, the environment, how good the personnel in that hotel related to them. But one little experience for someone else can also cause the person to rate it as a 1-star hotel. So the question is, should we just consider a hotel 5 stars just because of the ratings on the internet? Because for example, there's a hotel in my village, very humble place, but the place is neat, the personnel are good, so it's always rated 5 stars. So would you consider that hotel 5 stars, even though it may not have that form of luxury? What do you consider before rating a hotel 5 stars? This is my outfit of the day. So how do I look? Completely covered. Of course, you're in Mali, what do you expect? All right. I hope you enjoy the place, you like the place as one of the 5-star hotels here in Mali. Yeah.
The couch is here. So beautiful. The place is so cool. Those are jewelry stuff.
Okay. Thank you.
Sorry.
All right.
Sorry for my English.
Oh, it's very good. It's the best. It's the best. Because I go to places. Ghana. Yes. So is it a 5-star hotel?
Yes, 5-star.
5-star.
Yes.
Okay.
Malian 5-star.
Malian 5-star.
Yeah.
All right. So if you want to spend a night, what is the price range?
The price for the room rate?
Range.
Bed and breakfast are $123. No. Local currency. And dollar, I think it is $215.
$215. Oh, that's so cool. Okay. All right. Thank you. Okay.
You want to book?
Yeah, I'm asking.
$215
is cool. I can book. Yeah.
Okay.
Book
no problem.
Right.
For when?
Now?
Oh,
not now.
Right. Take one room. What is your name?
Mabel.
May?
Mabel.
Mabel.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Gaston. Really?
No.
I want to jump through the roof.
I'm from Ghana.
Yeah.
I'm from Ghana.
But you speak good English.
It's
better because I meet a lot of people. I can only make signs. So it's very difficult. But you have a nice place. So I'm going. Let me just.
Now the swimming pool is.
It's ready.
Auto for them.
Ah, yeah, they are working on it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I came here already and they told me that they serve only snake here. And I ran away.
Okay, you can do here, no problem.
Yeah. Inside. Thank you. Thank you.
See you next.
To smoke?
No, yes, to smoke.
Wow, that is one thing I get from all Malian people. Everybody else smokes.
How are you?
Why?
Smoke and drink.
Why? But I don't see them drink that much, but I just see them smoke. In Ghana, people hide. They don't smoke in the open. But Mali, you can see everybody smoking. It's okay. Anyway, maybe it's a lifestyle. It's cool. Anyway, nice to meet you. I'll see you. Your boss was so nice, but okay. Come. Thank you very much.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's okay. I understand. Because of privacy.
But, what? 26th?
Oh, January.
Yes.
Okay, they will be done with the pool. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. That's cool. All right.
Okay, cool, Bali.
Thank you. In Mali, I get a lot of good vibes. Yes. Thank you. So, that place is for what? An outdoor bar or something. Okay, thank you. This area is called what?
Tosai.
This place is called Tosai.
No, the place? Azalai Hotel.
Yes, Azalai Hotel, but the community here.
Catch the flame.
It's not Handelai.
No,
Handelai. Okay. Catch the flame. Hey, Charlie. Catch the flame.
City administrative.
Thank you so much. All right. I'm going to Atetebubu. Yes. Merci. Yeah. Very far. Nice to meet
okay.
you. Okay, bye. Enjoy your night.
Okay.
Bye. So
mm-hmm.
Okay. Bonsoir.
Ça va bien.
Ah, ça va bien. Très bien.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
C'est quoi? Ring.
Yeah. Ring and bracelet.
A
good price.
How much?
Which one?
Ah, I have to choose. I think, the ring. I have that one already. Oh, what's the price? Oh, these are the things they sell here. How much is it?
$15.
Oh, I'll come later.
Okay, give me
time. I'll come later, seriously. I'll come later. Today I didn't prepare. I didn't know they have something like this here. It's a nice place. Wow, what is that?
For the
camel. Oh, okay. I'll come. I know. I'll come, okay. This is your number?
Yeah.
I can take?
Yeah.
Ghana.
Huh?
Ghana. Yeah, I'm from Ghana. All right.
Okay.
No, I like the bracelet.
Thank you. So guys, if you enjoyed the video, kindly give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe. I'm ending it here and I hope you like it. Leave your beautiful comments. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, bye. A bientôt.
Oh, you guys, look at the place. Thank you so much. Thank you.
If there's something I'm not doing right, kindly tell me. Like, I want to know. I want to know what I'm not doing right. So this is the car that serves the hotel. Takes you from here to the airport. Okay. Thank you. I'm gonna go catch the bus and get back home.